This is for Rachel, you big, fat, white, nasty, smelling, fat woman. Your stank is so tangible. I should be spelled differently, but that is correctly used. Why you take me off the schedule with your tawdry, noxious self. Here, what I would encourage you to do in writing the story is use the words so that we have a context clue, right? Rather than piling up adjectives. But yes, that could work there. Tawdry, noxious self, big, obdurate woman. Now, I'm guessing the person is stubborn. That's why she's being called obdurate. We've got some clarity on that, right? Oopa loopa body looking bigot. I'm coming up there, and we're gonna fight you. And you best believe these words are credible, or it's over for you. Okay, so far I guess that's working. You did all of this on purpose, you reprehensible woman. Okay, that fits. I don't care if I don't sound plausible. I'm going to find you and beat you up.
Everything is gay nowadays. I'm like, yo, bro, does my outfit look good? He goes, nah, I'm not gay. Oh, neither am I. Great. Tell me if it looks good or not, fucko. I didn't ask you to come over here and just slap me in the ass and call me dad. I asked you to tell me if this looked good together. So please tell me, does this match or no, you stupid.
Here's the plan. You, me, we move to Washington, D.C., we work a minimum wage job, live in a one-bedroom apartment, we make ends meet, that's okay, we're happy. You fall in love with a law student, I fall in love with a bartender who has daddy issues and a heart of gold. One night, we're out late, we're at a monument, maybe we're a little high, we see a carving in the back of the statue, we decide to look into it, why not? The law student gets us into a secret section of the Library of Congress, he's doing a report on it. Who bursts in? The FBI. We've uncovered something. We're scared. We're confused. We're in the holding cell, and who busts us out through the air vents? The bartender with daddy issues and a heart of gold. We come up with a plan. What do we steal? Not the Declaration of Independence. The Articles of Confederation. We take it to the statue and the carving. It's a cipher. Ben Franklin was homosexual. But that's okay. We Ben knew.
Le cheval était pionnier, le viton j'étais, et le jonton le hoppa, le chison l'était en poids.
That awkward moment when you're at the mall food court and you're just trying to enjoy your meal and you're with your friend and she just keeps farting and she won't stop. Oh, and everyone's staring at you because she keeps passing gas and it's not on me.
Almost heaven, West Virginia, Blue Ridge Mountain, Shenandoah River. Life is old there, older than the trees, younger than the mountain. Blowing like a breeze, country road, take me home to the place I belong, West Virginia, mountain mama, take me home, country road, country road. Take me home to the place I've been.
Honestly, they are so cute together. He treats her so well. Like, I have really high standards for her, but I'm so glad that she has someone who just treats her so well, and I really like him as a person, and they are just the cutest couple. Like, look at them. They're so cute. I can't even stand it. I'm so happy for them. I support them so much, and I love them both so much.
Oh god, you guys are so gross. What are you, dating someone of the opposite gender? That's gay.
So apparently when someone like finds you cute or like thinks that you're attractive and wants to be with you, like they chase you, you know what I mean? Like they won't stop until they get you. Is that why the police is always chasing me? Like, do they have a little crushy-washy? Oh my god. Do you think I should go up to them next time? Like, do you think I should say something or... I'm so nervous.
So yeah, like, I might be here physically, but emotionally,
I'm in a 1940s boarding school, and I've just fallen in love with a tall blonde boy in my English class. He has a lot of opinions on poetry and Keats, and everyone groans every time he talks, and I giggle just that little bit too loud. He's flirty when he's drunk, and then he becomes flirty when he's sober. After one of our many nights of reading poetry under the stars, he turns to me, quotes Wilde, and kisses my nose. And he calls me darling. And I could never have been more happy. So we run away. We find abandoned cottage, take care of stray cats. We drink, we read, we smoke. He smokes very erotically, not that he'd ever notice. And we love each other. But like, other than that, I'm here, Yori.
My brother just asked me if I woke up this morning and just decided I was gonna dress up as an old lady lesbian.
No, not an old lady lesbian. An old lady and a lesbian. They're two separate characters. The bottom half of you looks like they're homophobic. They're blaming the gays on the horrible economy, but the top half of you is a muffin muncher.
I'm currently home alone because my parents went out of town for the weekend, so I've been staying here by myself. But while I was at a babysitting job this evening, my grandparents came over, and when they left our doors unlocked, and they left our blinds up, and they left our alarm system off, so it is safe to say that I will be murdered tonight. The only question is when and where. And you know what? That's where it gets interesting, ladies and gentlemen, because I went through and I checked every closet and every room in our house, and I did not find the murderer, which leads me to the conclusion that I will be killed by either a contortionist or a very small person, because if they're not in any room and they're not in any closet, they're in a drawer somewhere or in a cabinet or in a trunk or a box, and they are folded up and waiting to kill me, and I respect that. I respect the theatrical value of that. They didn't just come in here and stab me. They're gonna wait till I turn off the lights and they're gonna run at me in a back bend or on there walking on their hands and struggling with their feet, and I respect that. Like, honestly, if you can hear me, I'm the first door on the right. Like, honestly, you can just come kill me.